Hello everyone! In this series, we're going to learn how to build interactive experiences using animated Bitmoji 3D avatars. In the first video, we'll get acquainted with the easiest way to gather some Bitmoji animations that can streamline the development of your lenses and even help you build gaming experiences. For this project, we're going to need Lens Studio 5. We'll also be checking out the platform solutions sections of the docs.snap.com website. Click on Bitmoji avatar when you get there. Take some time to learn about the Bitmoji 3D component and where to find it in this video. And then I'll jump straight to the animating Bitmoji 3D section. If you don't have any 3D modeling or animation experience, using the Mixamo library might be the easiest way for you to start building Bitmoji 3D lenses. Let's go ahead and download this FBX file from the Lens Studio website and log in to the Mixamo website. Now, we need to upload our custom character, since the Bitmoji rig is pretty specific and the animation generated for default character won't work out of the box. Click the Upload Character button and drag in the file we just downloaded. This might take a minute or two. Once the character file is uploaded and processed, click the Next button. At this point, you should see this cute girl in the preview. This is the one we're going to be working with. From here on, everything is straightforward, and you may work with the animation library as usual. Once you've selected the animation you like, adjust its settings. Tweak the character's arm space to account for different body types. Trim or mirror the animation. When you're done tweaking, click the Download button. In the Download dialog, choose Without Skin. Because we'll be using Bitmoji avatar downloaded in runtime, select FBX format and 30 frames per second. Repeat this process as many times as needed. Now, let's import these files to Lens Studio. Make sure to have legacy importer disabled. Add Bitmoji 3D component to scene. Enable Adapt to Mixamo checkbox and add imported clip through the animation player component attached to the same scene object. This should allow us to see animation playing right away. Of course, you might notice that these animations lack certain hand or face movements. In the next video, you'll learn how to create completely custom animations in Maya, or check out video number 3 if you'd like to learn how to smoothly transition between animations, trigger them based on events, and blend between animation clips. Thank you for watching.